Well, hello, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarland.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. And we had outlaws, and we had drought, and we had smallpox, terrible winters, cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson is a menace, and men like him are the plague. But isn't a government agent a worse menace? And all that symbolizes, I mean.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. But you tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. And sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie. We got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime. Apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on. I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston. Now you got some rope on your belt. Let's see if we can't wrangle some horses.
Slow it up now. You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
They ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshall got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret who sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches would steal a coin off a dead man's eye.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics.
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy the ride?
But I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. And there's few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better, if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland.
Had him there. Keep at it, Marston.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Give me too much rope to play with. You gonna use that rope or not? Activity for an old timer like me. I'll take this one back to the ranch. See you later.
Come on, then. Let's see if you can get another one.
Come on.
What are you waiting for?
And slow down. So many folks in trouble.
It'll sap your spirit and make you poor, but it's straight and it's decent.
There's no better night's sleep than after an honest day's work.
It's no wonder you look so tired then.
Some deck must be shy of Joker, Miss McFarland.
Who'd have thought you'd be such a natural at busting broncos?
That was fun.
I think you could be a fine rancher one day if you can bear to stop killing people.
Hey, Bonnie. Amos was saying some horses been spotted somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We can really do with those horses. No rest for the wicked. Let's see if we can track down that other herd of horses.
You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure ask a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a catch.
The fact that you're talking in the past says it all.
No, that's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Some, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little, well, you know, countryfied.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarland?
From a couple of cheap governesses, Paul hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes, that's all. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He'd never admit it, but my pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarland.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much. Looks like the ranch hand's up ahead.
Thank you.
Right you are, miss. Let's go. Easy up there.
They are. Hey, the stallion's getting away! Chase him down and bring him back!
Yeah!
for your help today, Mr. Marston. We got some fine horses. You know, why don't you keep that stallion as your own, as a thank you from all of us?
Thank you, ma'am. He's a fine animal.
Some help, partner. Name's Errol Hewitt. The damn Bollard gang stolen my family's herd. I gotta get them back. They're all I got.
I'm gonna put you down.
Your dog's name?
I like it.
Goodbye, gentlemen!
Sorry, partner.